With all the queries we've worked through in this course so far, we've always been trying to pull out, well, just a set of rows, essentially the exact information more or less that we threw into the database. Moving forward, however, as we continue to look at some more complicated queries, we're going to introduce two additional techniques. One is called grouping, the other is called aggregates or aggregation. The goal with these two techniques is to take a big set of values or a big set of rows and somehow condense them down to a smaller set of values. With grouping in particular, we're going to take many rows, so we're going to write a query that's going to select or somehow obtain many different rows, and then we're going to somehow group those rows to some fewer or lesser number of rows. So the result of grouping is rows. We execute grouping by using the group by SQL keyword. When you first get started with grouping, it's really kind of challenging to tackle when you first get started, particularly as you start to select data or select columns out of the grouped information. To avoid those challenges, the best thing to do is to really visualize what happens when you apply the group by keyword. As long as you kind of get a mental picture in your head of what group by does, life starts to get really easy. So as we start this grouping by stuff, we're going to take a look at a lot of different diagrams to really understand what it does for us. Okay, so the other thing we're going to talk about is aggregates. The goal of an aggregate is to take many different values and reduce them down to one value. So when I use the term values here, I'm really talking about distinct values inside of a column of data. So we might take many rows, we might select one column out of all those different rows, and then apply an aggregate function to them. It's going to take all those different values in those different columns and condense it down to one single value. We apply aggregates or create aggregations by using an aggregate function. All right, so honestly, we could lecture about these things all day, but it makes a lot more sense to just write some code and play around with them a little bit. Let's pause right here and then start learning about grouping and aggregations in our sample dataset.